So this video is all about configuring Code GPT extension using the Azure OpenAI service. The first step is to configure Azure OpenAI service. Navigate to the portal and find your OpenAI service and note down this endpoint. Then go to the keys and endpoint blade, find the key, then copy the key value. These values we'll be using in the extension to configure it to use this Azure OpenAI service. Then go to the model deployments. We have to make sure the model is deployed into the Azure OpenAI service. Click on the manage deployment. We will reach to the Azure AI Studio. In the Azure AI Studio, we can go to the deployments blade. We need to make sure that GPT-4 is deployed. It may work with GPT-3.5 as well, but personally I have tested only with the GPT-4. Now we need to prepare the URL that we will be using to configure the extension. Get the endpoint first. Then to the endpoint, we have to suffix the URL. It will look like this once it is prepared. Now install the extension, and it is a matter of second to get it installed. In this machine, I had already installed. Now let us see how this can be configured. Either you use the menu, or we can click the Ctrl Shift P in Windows. Here we can see an option called Code GPT :set Azure data. Select that option. The first is the URL that we prepared. Paste here, enter, then paste the API key that we copied from the portal. Enter to confirm. Then there will be a prompt coming saying that please reload the window to apply the changes. Another setting what we need to do is in the extension configuration, we have to change the AI provider to Azure. Similarly, the model also need to be changed to Azure. This is needed because we are going to use a Azure OpenAI service. Now I restarted the VS Code window. Then we can see one extra option coming here, Code GPT chat. Once we click here, it will load a window here. Now it is a time to experience AI. In my code, there is a function. The function name is just to find, it is accepting a number, doing something and returning a result. So I would like to understand what is this function. So I am selecting the function and I am selecting the option explain the selected code. So we can see it is sending the request explain selected code. Then it started painting the results. As we can see, the AI started working. So it says the code defines a method named find that calculates the square root of a given number. Here you can see there's no word at all that is related to the square root, but the AI is able to find out this is square root. Then we can see a lot of explanation, how it is working, what is mean by the precision, and much more details. This is more a general algorithm. Let me see another use case where it is using a specific library. So here I have a SharePoint operation class. So let me select this line and find what is the meaning of this function. Explain the selected code. So it identified the function, even it is able to understand this related to SharePoint. If you look at here, there's no detail at all related to SharePoint. So it identified this code is for reading all the folders from a document library in a SharePoint site. And it is explaining about the arguments. Even it is saying there's a comment. Command warns that method will not work the number of library items exceeds 500. But the command says when the items cross 5000. But somehow 10 is missing here. Yeah, I think it's not there yet. So it is trying hard to become a pair programmer. If you are wondering how this is working behind the scene, please have a Fiddler installed and look at the traffic. Everything going on here is a web API. So here there's a URL that we are given to configure the extension, and it's giving the JSON request message. There are two types of messages, a system and the user. This is the basics of ChatGPT. So I don't want to go the details of what is system and what is user. Once we give these details, it will be giving the result. These results are what formatted by the extension and making a user-friendly view. Thanks for watching the video. Comments are welcome. We will see you with more interesting stuff in the future. Bye.